Hey, and what is happening, guys? Yankee here. We're back for some more Let's Play Banjo-Tooie. In this part, we're finishing out the rest of Click Clock Wood. I mean, Cloud Cuckooland. I'm just messing with you guys. I wouldn't make that same mistake three times now, would I? But anyway, yes, we actually get to do a lot of things with Banjo in this part because in the last one, we actually unlocked a lot of things. We pretty much planted those beans that can let us get to two different areas with Banjo because he can only get there by himself because the jiggies we'll be getting with him are only, able to get with using Banjo. I guess that's the only way I can put it. And we just gotta be very careful getting across this little thorn bush area right here. Gotta watch that Zuba and, come on. Just hop across. Okay. That was a close one. I didn't want to fall off the side, because once you fall off the side, you are doomed. This is a very unforgiving level with the mountainside. If you fall off, you're dead. So basically, we're just gonna float on over and climb up that beanstalk that we, basically grew up in the last one, and head inside. If you saw before, it looked like a giant block of cheese, so I don't know. This is actually one of the more frustrating jiggies to get, because you have to platform with the new move we learned in this part. And I'm just gonna say it right here, this part is probably gonna stink, no pun intended. Not looking forward to this end. Let's just hop over. Okay, got a little nervous there. For some reason, I thought I could make that jump, but luckily I caught myself, and here we go. Inside the cheese wedge. Yeah, I wasn't even kidding. This place does really stink. If you see on the left, we have a air gauge. Basically, Banjo can actually die if he spends too much time here. And we have to use that new move to platform on what looks like halves of onions with spikes coming out of them. So that's actually pretty cool if they would even like put that, because onions smell, obviously. I'm surprised Banjo's not crying, but hey, he's got a tough sense of smell, I guess. Or maybe he doesn't have any sense of smell at all, because he's being a trooper right here. And oh, is it Jinjo? Is he a friend or a foe? I think he's friendly. Let's go touch him. There we go. 9 out of 9. The Black Jinjo family is complete. Wow, 9 of them. That's one of the largest Jinjo families too, so wow, we actually completed that family. That just shows something that we've collected so many Jinjos on our journey so far. And as you saw right there, we actually went a little around the cheese wedge and used one of our other Banjo moves to get the jiggy that's hidden inside. So 79 jiggies, we have 90 to collect in the game, so 11 more to go. What I was thinking actually, since we're gonna finish this part probably in this one, the next part's pretty much gonna be a giant recap of going back to all the other worlds, collecting everything we need, all 90 jiggies, all the notes and whatnot, all the collectibles. Then the part after the next part will pretty much be finishing the game. I think this Let's Play only has like 5 more parts to it. I mean, it's just gonna be such a relief to finish, like, not a relief, but it's gonna be so like awesome to finish this Let's Play, because I've been really bad with doing Let's Plays the last couple of Let's Plays, because I have like 3 incomplete Let's Plays right now that I never finished. And with completing this one, that's gonna be the first time I think I completed a Let's Play in like over a year. And I'm sorry, Banjo, we're gonna have to make you go over the edge. Hey, at least he landed in that pink area. Maybe Heggy's? Sorry, Heggy, I'll fix the roof later. But anyway, it was an egg, it was meant to be cracked, you know, Humpty Dumpty and all that. See, now let's go to the Mumbo side that we hatched that egg and grew that beanstalk, because now we can do Mr. Fitz's second challenge. Basically, his second challenge looked like a sack race. And since we learned that new move, we have a sack of our own, our backpack. And let's just take out this bee right now before he causes us any trouble. And okay, I jumped over him. Oh, whoa, that was close. All right, let's see. Banjo's, I just hate Banjo's attack too. Like, just like Mumbo, it's very limited range and but we got him anyway, so we can make our way across and float on over, climb up the beanstalk, and partake in a sack race. Yeah, I don't know what made a sack race like one of those family events that you would, basically we always have a family reunion and we always have a sack race. I don't know, I was always a fan of the two-legged race. Sack race, it was actually, I remember how the Grinch Stole Christmas, like the remake with Jim Carrey, like that was a pretty funny scene when he's doing the sack race, he just knocks all the kids over. But unfortunately we can't do that, we're just gonna face Mr. Fit. Hey, we can't trip over any innocent children, oh well. So there we go, we got our sack, let's approach him and let's do the race. And yes, we have our own sack. Basically, we're gonna be doing a little tiny cheat. It's, I don't know if you consider it cheating since it's part of the course, but it actually reminds me of this area right here, is that in Super Mario Kart for the SNES, that racetrack on the ghost one of the ghost tracks basically had a little ramp like that you can just drive up across, and if you got like a certain boost or whatever. It just always reminded me of that shortcut, of that one of those ghost races, but anyway, or ghost tracks. We have beat him for the second time, and he says we must have cheated. That wasn't really cheating, we just knew the course. I mean, sorry? You could have done the same thing, but Banjo, it's time for your demise again. How many times have I- oh god. Okay, Banjo, at least you won't- I don't know. It would have been better just to, like, he would have died with the lack of oxygen falling down, but now I just gave him brain damage, so he's dead on impact, so... either way, he's quote-unquote dead, because he's right before our eyes now. He's all fine. So, yeah, I don't know, like, really, death in this game, I've mentioned this many times, is just a great shortcut. I mean, in the last game, they made death have a consequence. If you died, you lost all your notes, and... you only had a certain limited number of lives, even though you can just continue from where you left off, so it's kind of pointless to have lives, but the main thing was the notes. I mean, if you died, you lost all your notes that you collected in the world, so that was a huge, huge upgrade from the last game in this one, which is why this game, I think, is a little bit worse. I think they tried to do a bit too much in this game. They made the world way too big, and it's really... well, at least I uncovered a Globo. I mean... I actually have to remember to pick that up, because I think we'll be doing that later after we're done with this Kazooie thing right here. But like I was just saying, wrapping up, Banjo-Tooie, I don't like it as much as Banjo-Kazooie, obviously. I think it's way too big, and the game is way too easy. So yeah, Banjo-Kazooie always be my favorite of the two games. I don't know if anyone asked this before, but I always prefer Banjo-Kazooie. Gotta love the classics. But anyway, what I wanted to do over here is get the running shoes, because we'll be doing the Mr. Fit Challenge number 3 right away after we did the second one, because it's a foot race, and now we got our running shoes. And yes, we have our running shoes on. Let's beat him in a little 40-yard dash. How you think we're going to win this one? I guess by cheating. Yeah, well, we got our running shoes. I mean, it'd be kind of hard to run barefoot, so this race we're actually going to win. He's actually pretty fast. You just want to get ahead of him just in case, because he'll push you up. And there we go, we win the little race just with Kazooie. So we beat him with Kazooie, Banjo, and then Kazooie. A bag of feathers, or more than that. Come on, we were a dragon once. There we go, we beat him in all three events, and he's gonna go off to a gym. I don't think they have gyms in the clouds, especially in this crazy world. And whoa. You got the Banjo treatment there, but you died very swiftly, so I mean, it was not painful, hopefully. But yes, let's actually, how do we want to get to the next Jiggy? I think we're actually going to go and get that Globo and transform, which will be our last transformation in the game, unfortunately, but it's actually one of my more favorite transformations in the game. Is a nice little throwback, actually, to, and this is why I keep making the references to Click Clock Wood. You really think I'm doing that on purpose, but this last world actually reminds me of a lot of Click Clock Wood, and, the last transformation pretty much is why, whoops, I got that by accident, didn't mean to do that. What we want to do is actually go by where Canary Mary is, because that's where, Wumba is, and it's just gonna be, I'm really not looking forward to, the Canary Mary getting that Cheeto page. That is a very tough race. That is the race I was actually thinking of that was very tough. The one to get the Jiggy is very easy, but the second Canary Mary race is quite arguably one of the hardest races in the game, but I found a way to actually beat her, and I actually looked this up. It's a very proven technique to beat her, so I'll be showing that off, but if you don't know this, it might be a little tough if you don't know that technique, so I'll be showing that off, and I'm not looking really forward to it, but hopefully I can do it in the first try. I think I can. But yeah, there's actually a Jinjo up there that we can get. Basically, we'll just have to transform first to reach it, so... obviously, you get the idea that this transformation involves some sort of flight and a relationship to the enemies that I've been hating in this world, so... we become one of them! We are a bee once again, just like in Click Clock Wood, but we have a lot more things going on. Basically, we can fly whenever we want by double-clicking A, and now we have a stinger attack. That is a major, major plus, and this is why the bee is one of the best transformations in the game. And basically right here, I'm just fast-forwarding this part because I had a tough time getting this Jinjo. The flight is very finicky, and the camera certainly did not help, so... sorry if this is a little, out of place, but I just had to speed this up. You guys did not want to sit here and watch me do this for 2 minutes, so... let's just get up here, get the Jinjo, and there we go, Jinjo 7 out of 8. Awesome. Alright, so now that we have the transformation, let's actually go and take out these guys that have been bugging us that we couldn't do anything about, but now that we're the bee. And yes, someone's flying in here. Defend your Jiggy at all costs. We can now attack these guys with the stinger attack. Get them right in the eye. And there we go, we can get that Jiggy now. Oh, you gotta pass it on, okay. So there's a number of these guys we actually have to beat because they keep teleporting the Jiggy somehow. I don't know why Grunty wouldn't just do that with all the Jiggies, but let's not get into detail. But anyway, I think the next one is actually by where the water was. So we just gotta make our way over there. So yeah, it could be a little boring. I wish the bee was actually a bit faster in flight and had the ability to do like that Banjo torpedo attack in midair, but no, we just gotta go around nice and slowly and get these guys one by one. So yeah, once we get this Jiggy, I believe there's three more or two more we have to hit after this. We'll be going up to the top of the mountain, I believe, and taking on a challenge. Another mini game, yeah, a little bit redundant, but yeah, we gotta do it. And yeah, we're almost done with this world, so let's see, there he is, okay. All right, you gotta dodge his, he's an eyeball plant that attacks with eyeballs. Isn't that a bit redundant? But anyway, the next one's actually up there, so let's just fly up to the mountaintop and take it out. And I'll just speed it up right here because, you know. All right, so we're up here, and basically, when I actually did this first thing on my practice run, I took out the wrong eyeball plant by accident, and I actually did that in this one too. So basically what I did was I took out the third eyeball one, which is by the beanstalk, getting up to the sack race or the, it's by one of those things, one of the beanstalks. I took out that plant, thought that was like the next one I had to take out, but that wasn't. That was actually the one of the third to last ones I had to take out. So yeah, basically I got very confused and I sat around for like 5 minutes thinking what to do, so I made another cut. And we're moving on to this. Basically, we have to shoot this thing 20 times in 10 seconds, so you just gotta get right nice in front of it because it's actually pretty difficult. We only have 5 seconds left to do that. And we gain entry inside of the Zuba's Hive. So, just like in Click Lock Wood, we're befriending these guys once again. And this mini game right here actually is weird because I'll just show it off. It's very weird. Basically, we got a new bee right here, the Zuba's Nest, and they're gonna say, you wanna play a game, 40 points or more, and you get a prize. And you get an extra prize if you do more points, I guess. And we don't need any instructions. Basically, 3, 2, 1. We will be killing off other Zubas? Like, it's very strange how these Zubas have, like, games like this. We're killing other maybe it's a hate crime, I don't know, but we're killing off their own kind to do this minigame. Given permission by the kind. Like, this is like a genocide. Like, why would you kill your own people like this? I guess because you don't allow blue, red, and green bees? Well, I guess they're bees. They're not officially Zubas, so they have to die. But anyway, yeah, if you just fly around with the bee, it's actually very easy. I didn't know that you could fly around my first time, so I actually, like, went stationary and just shot where you started from. And obviously, the laws. I was like, wow, I actually got very smoked here. But no, you had to fly around and just fly in a circle and fire about. And once again, a very easy minigame. And this is just another comparison to Banjo-Kazooie. This is what made Banjo-Kazooie so great, was they didn't have all these time-consuming and very easy minigames. Like, this is what actually brought down the challenge of Banjo-Tooie. It was very disappointing because you got a lot of repeats too. And that's what made Banjo-Kazooie great, had a lot of innovative cheats, like, you can get. In this game, they gave, like, each world, like, 3 minigames, and it's very, like, boring, I don't know. And we got enough to get the first and second prize, thank goodness, we don't have to do that over twice. I wish the Canary Mary race was like that, but nope, we gotta go back and do that. So I think after we get this Jiggy and Cheeto page, that's all that's left in this world. Actually, wait, we have to do one more thing. One more thing, and that's getting the safes Jiggy. And that will actually lead us to the rest of the notes in this world as well, so. Alright, so let's get the Cheeto page right here, and I think we are done with the bee. And no, we don't want to do the mini game over. It's not that exciting. Alright, so let's untransform right here and go back to where Wumba is. And luckily it's not too far away, but still, I wish the bee would go a little bit faster. But oh well, so I think after this we'll use the fly pad that's around here. I guess we'll fly over, we'll transport over with the plant over to that area where the George the Ice Cube was. Fly to the top of the mountain and unlock the last number of the safe and collect the rest of the notes, and then we are up for that final race with Canary Mary. Ugh. You know what? It's for the last Cheeto page in the game, and yeah, I'll actually be, I think I'm going to be using the cheats that I unlock because I rationalized it myself, and it's not like I'm cheating. Yeah, a lot of cheating in this, like these last couple parts with the races included. But you had to collect all these Cheeto pages. I didn't have to do this, and it's not like I just looked up on the internet and typed in a cheat. So yeah, I'll be using the cheats that that Cheeto will be giving us, and some people might complain about one of the cheats that I got, I think, already that I didn't activate yet, but I mean, I collected all the Cheeto pages. I deserve a reward, so I'm definitely going to be doing that. So sorry if that makes the game like 10 times easier with the final boss, but I think I deserve it. I mean, what do you guys think? I mean, if you don't think it's fair, then maybe I won't do it, but it's kind of like getting the red honeycombs in the last one. I mean, that's a well-deserved reward. I like how this game has well-deserved rewards that you get by collecting things. Like, some games don't have that. You collect a lot of things, you get a crappy reward, so that's why I think I'll be using it, because I worked hard to get these Cheeto pages. What was the point then? So this is where I wanted to fly up to, right here, this point. A lot of people miss this one, actually, so, and I actually missed this one, too. I actually had to go back and do it. Okay, I almost fell off the side. Don't want to do that. But basically, we have this tight little pathway, and one of our friends, of course, Azuba. They really went all out in this world, putting the Zubas in the most unideal locations possible to fall off the side. Alright, so let's actually, do we want to blow it up first? Yeah, I don't have the homing eggs cheat on, I don't think so. I thought I had him there, but let's actually make our way across with the clockwork egg, see if that works. And there we go. That worked, I guess, but I don't want to walk over here with Banjo because we're just in case the Zuba respawns, so I'm trying to get the clockwork egg to go across for me because we're going to need it anyway to unlock the last safe number, which is on the other side. So there we go. Ooh, nice spot right there. We gotta make it over fast before that Zuba regenerates. I just heard it, and okay, come on. Come on, little clockwork. Oh, come on, really? Alright, let's try it again. We gotta do this fast, though. Okay, got a little pattern down. Shoot, there we go. Perfect. I think I got it this time. So yeah, I could have walked across, but well, I take the chance. I mean, the clockwork egg is a very useful egg, probably one of the best, and why not use it to get across nice and safe? Safe and sound. Yeah, I think we only have 10 more notes to go to get all 900 notes in the game. So 90 jiggies and 900 notes, and the secret number was 1984. Oh yeah, 1984. I should have remembered that. It's a really rare date. I think that's when Rare was first created, or obviously has a very significant year for Rare, so I would think that maybe be the case. So don't quote me on that, but I think that's what it is. So yeah, it's a pretty cool. I like how Rare makes all these Easter eggs to its company and whatnot, just like Twycross and Rusty Bucket Bay on the ship, because that's where the company it was based off of in England, I believe. So yeah, now that we have that, and we're going to go to the safe and get the Jiggy, it is time for the Canary Mary race, and these guys actually looked up their names. The enemy names are Flatzos. So yeah, they're not gingerbread men with weird weapons, they're Flatzos. So, yeah, I always thought that was funny, and there we go. We got the Jiggy inside the safe, 7 more Jiggies to go, and let's just view our tolls right now just to make sure that's the Cheeto page is the only thing left. And it is, and we actually beat this world in about an hour. Like, as the last world in the game, it's actually one of the easier worlds. A lot of people say they have trouble with this world, but I actually thought it was one of the easier ones. Grunty Industries was 10 times tougher, took me twice as long to do. Hellfire Peaks took a lot of time, but it wasn't too bad. But this one was just like a very nice last world to do, and it was very fun too. It was very wacky and creative too. So I enjoyed it very much, just like Click Clock Wood, which was very innovative too, as well, with the different seasons. And we can get over here very fast with the fly pad, and we're just gonna land right here and take on the Canary Mary challenge. Okay. Basically, I'm gonna tell you the strategy how to be Canary Mary here. Right now, I just had to cut away right there. Sorry about that. But to be Canary Mary in this race, you're gonna have to go in a methodical pace. Basically, you're not gonna wanna go as fast as you can. The faster you go, the faster Canary Mary will go. So it's kinda like rubber band AI, which I found out. So what you wanna do is not go too fast, but get like a nice pattern going and conserve your energy. This race is twice as long as the last one. The first time I tried this, I went as fast as I could, and I just died out like 3/4 of the way there. So you wanna just keep a nice pace And just know that your pace is pretty much how fast Canary Mary will go, so you don't want to go too fast. And basically, if you want, you can just have stretches where you just button mash the hell out of it, then go back to going at a consistent pace just to get some, like, speed going. So you don't want to fall too far behind, so yeah, it's actually nice that this race tours around the whole entire Cloud Cuckooland. I don't know why they would make the Cheeto Page race the tougher of the two. I think that the Cheeto Page one should have been the first race, then this should have been the Jiggy race, but yeah, this is actually one of the hardest things to get in the game. It's just for a Cheeto Page, so it's kind of like, really? And let's just go a little faster here. And it's going up a little. Let's see, how much of a lead do I have right here? I just want to be a little consistent right here, so let's go back to the pace. So yeah, I can hear her, but I don't see her. But yeah, just keeping up a pace right here. Okay, she's on her tail. We want to go, I think we just want to go fast here. Basically, I have enough energy to do this, so why not? But yeah, basically, you want to go slow and steady. We're not too slow. You just want to have a consistent pace, and that's how she'll race. If you go faster, she'll burn you. So yeah, there you go. Hope that helps if you're trying to do this Cheeto Page as well. And yes, you did. Sure. The lady hand over the papery thing. My last possession. Oh, I feel so bad now. Jeez. Well, that's it, Ed. I reckon I'll be off for dinner. What are you having? A nice worm sandwich and a tasty bag of millet. Ugh. Sounds good. How about a third race to let us try and win your dinner? Oh, Kazooie, you're a bird, so you like that kind of thing. And yeah, we don't want to win our last possession. Let's let her have dinner and eat. So, yeah, she's going home. So we're in the clouds already, so she's going higher than the clouds. Where is her home? In the freaking, like, double cloud land? Like heaven? I don't know, but let's fall to our doom last time, and we actually fell to Heggy's shack once again, or Heggy's egg shed. And there we go, we're done with Cloud Cuckooland. It conveniently put us right to the entrance, and down we go. So back to ILO Hags, basically, and those are the last two notes I didn't get. I don't know why I missed those. I thought I got them, but I didn't. So there we go. 895 and 900 notes. So we have 83 Jiggies and 900 notes. 7 more Jiggies to go, which we'll be getting in the next part by going around the different worlds in the game and pretty much doing one final recap and probably be getting the Cheeto Pages as well and the cheats activated. And then we're ready to take on or take steps toward the final boss in the game. So yeah, this LP is almost over and I can't wait. So anyway, I'll see you later, guys. And until next time, we'll be tackling Click Clock, what I'm just kidding. We'll be wrapping up and making our way to the final area. So I'll see you later, guys. And until next time.